So we change from the men to the women and from the C1 to the K1. Women in the Olympics do not do the canoe disciplines. Certainly strongly raced in North America, but they don't do the sea disciplines here. There's the start list for the women's K1, 200 meters. Zhao Yu goes for China in lane one. Natalia Sergeyeva of Kazakhstan goes in two. There is Spela Ponomarenko Janic. Lisa Carrington, the world champion, goes in lane four. Just shaded in her first round. Teresa Portela Rivas. Again, an impressive qualifier.
1 minute to the start.
Ina Osipenko Radomska, silver medalist in the 500 metres yesterday, had been the defending champion there. Came through strongly as well, as did Jenny Mikkonen of Finland. And San Diego's Carrie Johnson makes up this list here in this first semi-final. Again, the first two go through automatically to the final, plus the two best third placers. They'll go through to the A final. Then third to fifth will take you through to the B final automatically. And there'll be a best sixth place also.
Paddlers to the start line, please. Paddlers to the start line.
So the first semi final in the women's K1 200 metres. And Lisa Carrington just being asked to get herself sorted in lane four, the defending world champion.
Ready, set.
And away they go, a clean start this time, and Carrington looked to get a decent enough start in lane four there. The black boat coming away fairly quickly. Ponomarenko Janic as well for Slovenia, looking strong. And in the middle, you can see Teresa Portela Rives also going well. At the moment, Osipenko Radomska being left in the yellow and blue boat of Ukraine. It is instead Teresa Portela Rives of Spain and Lisa Carrington. These two at the moment pulling away from the field, and two to go through automatically to the A final. Carrington, the world champion. Teresa Portela Rives looking very strong in her fourth Olympic Games. And now Carrington puts the squeeze on, begins to come away, and Lisa Carrington for New Zealand going to take the semi-final. She comes through first, Portela Rives for Spain in second, and Osipenko Radomska for Ukraine will have to wait to see if she's one of the quickest third placers, but Carrington looking strong in this first semi-final.
Great start from Carrington, also from Portela Rives from Spain. They both came out really quick and then just gave themselves a battle almost just amongst the two of them. And then Carrington eventually just edging her nose ahead, really saw the power going through those blades as they got that tempo up nice and high.
Teresa Portela Rives chasing her hard all the way, but she takes second, just under 41 seconds. Thumbs up, job done. Teresa Portela Rives goes into tomorrow's final. We'll have to wait to see if Ina Osipenko Radomska there in lane six for Ukraine, if she's quick enough. A little bit of a gap though between her and the first two, so she might be struggling. The two best third placers go through from these three semi-finals.
Osipenko just didn't quite seem to find herself in the early part of that race, gave herself an awful lot to do to catch up. And on this 200 metres, it's a real tough challenge or a tough ask if you find yourself down at the halfway point.
Just lost out Lisa Carrington in the first heat to Natasa Douchev-Janics, who was alongside her. She did look very strong as well, but here coming through with a win. Carrington through, and there is a confirmation of that result again. Lots of Olympic best times being set today in these 200 metre races being run for the first time in the Olympics. Carrington lowers the time though, so quicker obviously than anyone in the heats this morning. And she and Teresa Portela Rives of Spain go through automatically. Osipenko Radomska will have to wait and see. Mikkonen and Ponomarenko Janic and Zhao Yu go into the B final. So we're ready now for heat two in the women's K1 200 metres. Again, lots of people fanning themselves down there in the stands. They're very, very hot indeed. We're still being encouraged to play imaginary bongos by the stadium announcer, the warm-up man. And some of them are even complying, which is remarkable.
As if they're not warm enough already, I say.
Lovely day for paddling about in the water, but very, very warm. The wind has just picked up a fraction, but again, very little really to give anyone a real advantage or disadvantage, which is, I suppose, what we want to see. And the forecast is similar for tomorrow, perhaps not quite as sunny, but warm and still. For the finals of these sprints, which we've been enjoying today, these new distances being raced for the first time in Olympic Games. For the second semi-final in the women's K1 200 metres. This is how they line up. Kitamoto very strong in the heats, as was Aldanius and Moldovan. Jess Walker going for Great Britain here. Is it Ivana Kmetova of Slovakia? There's Jess Walker, still just 22, but already this her second Olympic Games. So she found Beijing a real eye-opener on what she had to do to try and compete. It's going to be tough for her here to make it through in the top two. Henrietta Hansen from Denmark goes in lane three. There's one of the Moldovan sisters, Nikolina Moldovan. There's for her sister, Olivera Moldovan, in the K2 500 metres. Shinobu Kitamoto for Japan. 35 years old now, Kitamoto. Sofia Paldanias just missed out on a medal in the K1 500 metres.
In lane number 7 from the Russian Federation,
Natalia Lobova from Russia. She'll certainly be someone to figure with. And Margarita Ciszkiewicz of Belarus makes up the 8 in this semi-final. As the paddlers settle in the start buckets for the second semi-final in the women's K1 200 metres. Jess Walker going for Great Britain in lane two, but really up against the lane two to go through automatically in the best third place finisher over three semi-finals. And we're just going to false start. We mentioned you get false starts occasionally. And so they will wheel round and settle themselves and get ready to do it all again. I wonder who it was that got that false start. Not sure, it might have been a faulty start sometimes because the announcer there, before the alarm went off, was calling them back.
All paddlers return immediately to the start line.
Well, there's a push there from Ciszkiewicz in lane 8 from Belarus, so I'd be very surprised if she doesn't get a little warning against her.
Yeah, I didn't really see it first time around, but I certainly heard that on that replay.
All paddlers to the start line, please. Return immediately to the start line.
And again, you may wonder why you can get a false start when the buckets are there to stop you, but you push against them and then they drop and you've already got a little bit of momentum going forward, so you can get a little bit of a jump. And not as
Paddlers to the
there,
start line,
was,
please. Come immediately to the start line.
Margarita Ciszkiewicz in lane 8, I think we'll be given the warning. False start indeed against her. one more.
Paddlers to the start line, please.
The day will be over very
forward
quickly.
To the start.
So again, a fairly laborious process as they come
lane
in
two,
again.
Lane five.
Just confirm once again the start list
the
for
start,
this.
Please.
Look out for Kitamoto and Paldanius and Nicolino Moldovan as well. All went well
lane
in the heats
four.
This morning. Jess Walker trying to force herself into the top two here. But again,
lane
that
eight, Belarus,
is a tall
you
order.
Have a warning, full start.
And Maharita Shishkevich just being made
line,
clear.
Lane
she
six,
has a warning
lane
against
three,
her.
Forward.
Paldanius from Sweden
lane
last to come
five,
in.
Forward. Hold your positions there, please. Ready.
So one false start already, but we are settled again now for the second semi-final in the women's K1 200 metres. Jess Walker going for a great race up in lane two, and she gets most of the cheers, but they're going to have to work hard to lift her forward as others. And Shishkevich going nicely along at the bottom of the picture, but also going strongly. Kitamoto for Japan and Moldovan for Serbia at the moment. In lane five, it's Kitamoto, the Japanese paddler, out strongest at the moment, and a couple of metres up in her rivals, two to go through automatically. Jess Walker going well in lane two for Great Britain. Can she hold on at the moment? She is being lifted by this crowd, and Walker at the moment in second place. Kitamoto beginning to fade slightly. Natalia Lobova of Russia in lane seven going strongly now as they approach the finish line, and it looks as if Jess Walker is going to get there just in second place behind Natalia Lobova of Russia. But Walker makes it into the final. Fine effort from her, and Kitamoto, after her strong start, we'll have to wait and see if she makes it through as one of the fastest third place finishers. Lobova takes it, Jess Walker second. A fine effort from Walker, a fine race, and they are both through to the final.
Yeah, Walker really coming through there. That's come into the sort of last 150, didn't necessarily feature so much in that first 50 metres, but then really got her boat up and running and just kept etching away a little bit of pace and a little bit of speed down that final part.
Well, she finished eighth in the European Championships this year, so getting into the final there just, and the roar that's gone up is from the largely British crowd, which is just heard, just seen that it's been confirmed that Jess Walker has taken second place and goes automatically through to the final. I'm not sure she knows, she does now. Jess Walker into the final, this is why. We had Lobova of Russia taking it. We thought Kitamoto might see out Jess Walker, but no, by a couple of feet, Jess Walker into the final.
Off the start, Kitamoto really did get out very, very quickly and really died down that second part. There we see the Russian just jumping her boat across that line.
And she's patting her boat, saying well done. So she's perhaps slightly mad, but she's won that semi-final and did it well. Natalia Lobova. She takes the victory and takes the acclaim, but also going through with her to the final. A confirmation of that. Lobova first, Jess Walker going through in second place. A very, very good effort for her to make it through to the final of the Olympic Games in the women's K1 200 metres. Shinobu Kitamoto will have to wait to see if she's one of the fastest third place finishers.
Well, you are right, my friend, and we all see girls as they are setting up that top four.
Well, you must have been impressed with that, because Jess Walker, we thought she'd be up against it there, but coming through from lane two to take second place. And mighty effort as we look at the start list for the final semi-final here. The third semi-final, Natasa Douchev-Janics is a very powerful figure in this sport, and she'll be one to beat, I'm sure, come the final. I'm fairly certain she'll qualify for the final. That's not the commentator's jinx upon her. In lane one from Uzbekistan, Yulia Borzova. Daris Slades Amador from Cuba goes in lane two. Germany's Silke Hormann in lane three. Bit of a roar for Lana Nichols. Lots of Australian fans here. And there it is. Natasa Douchev-Janics, though. Hungarian fans here in force as well. Marta Walczykiewicz from Poland goes in lane six. Teresa Portela of Portugal in lane seven, and Emily Fournel of Canada makes up this semi-final. So again, eight here. First two go through automatically to the final, and there are two best third placers to go through to that final as well, to the A final. Third to fifth go through to the B final, just a battle out for the minor places. But again, really the favourites, I suppose, coming in here, Natasa Douchev-Janics in lane five for Hungary, Marta Valchakiewicz in six for Poland. Lana Nichols will be keen to get into that mix as well, and has a chance. She gets a very fast start, Nichols, faded a little bit in the heats.
Hold your positions there, please. Just hold your positions there. Ready.
Final semi-final in the women's K1, 200 metres, and away they go. And Douchev-Janics from Hungary in lane five looked to get away strongly, as did Nichols. And who will take it out over the first 50 metres? Valchakiewicz for Poland. She has the lead at the moment. Marta Valchakiewicz out in front, and a good lead at the moment from Valchakiewicz, from Douchev-Janics, and then Nichols just behind. Two to go through only here. Also going strongly, Teresa Portela for Portugal. But at the moment, it's still Marta Valchakiewicz. Now Douchev-Janics coming through, Nichols being left behind. She might have to set up a third, hope for a best time to come through. But it's Marta Valchakiewicz, in fact, Douchev-Janics coming through now, and it looks as if she's going to take it on the line. Good finish, well timed by Harshi. Shoots the boat over the line. First place to Douchev-Janics. Valchakiewicz in second. Alana Nichols coming through in third, I think, to see if she can get through with one of the fastest third place times. But again, no doubt about the winner, Natasha Douchev-Janics, started steadily and just picked up the pace. She took the victory in her heat. She's taken it again in the semi-final, looking good for the final tomorrow.
Yeah, she was building with every stroke. Rather than going out so hard, she just built it up and built it up.
Winner of this third semi-final, this last semi-final, the women's K1 200, and Marta Valchakiewicz confirmed as the second automatic qualifier through there.
That quick finish there, just launching her boat slightly, but it wasn't really the need, as she was a fraction ahead of the pole.
And Alana Nichols just getting in there, I think, for third place. Well, in fact, I think Teresa Portela from Portugal might have edged out Nichols. So Nichols won't even have the chance to make it through as one of the best third placers, because Teresa Portela from Portugal in lane seven just came through. Thought it was close, but it certainly was close. But I think Teresa Portela has got it. Douchev-Janics, though, out in front. Valchakiewicz alongside her in the white. And you see Teresa Portela just shooting her boat through there in lane seven, and that might have been just enough to get through. But Douchev-Janics and Valchakiewicz can celebrate their through automatically. Confirmation of the times as well. Teresa Portela 41.562. Just trying to see who's got the fastest two. Well, Teresa Portela will go through with that third place, and Osipenko Radomska from the first heat will go through as well. We'll wait for final confirmation of that, but Teresa Portela taking it. That time of Alana Nichols, she just sneaked up there, would have been good enough to get through to the A final, but losing out by three, well, I'm not sure what this out now, 0.3 seconds? That was close anyway. My arithmetic is fading in the heat here, but it doesn't really matter what the margin was. She finished fourth, and she is out. Winner of that one, Natasha Douchev-Janics. And these are the people who do go through to the A final. You see Teresa Portela getting in there, as was Osipenko Radomska. She finished third in the first heat. Jess Walker also in there, and that's not a bad lane to have going into the final. She finished second in her semi-final. And those women will contest the final tomorrow.